Ore miklat be ever hayarden. The Torah tells us to make three ore miklat in Eretz Israel and three ore miklat be ever hayarden. Three for the 9.5 shvatim and three for 2.5 shvatim. God, Reuven and Chatzi Menashe. These cities are the embassies to protect anybody who killed Beshogeg unintentionally. There's a mitzvah for the Goel Hadom to kill him, or a reshus according to Rabbi Akiva. So for protection, the Torah gives three Ore Miklot in each side of the Yarden. And he's not allowed to leave that Ore Miklot kol Yemei Chayov, as long as the Kohen Gadol is alive. The Gemara Masechta Makos Daf Tes Omed Beis asks a very obvious question. Is that fair that for 10 Shvotim you give 3 and for 2 Shvotim you give 3? Why isn't it divided evenly? Omer Abaye, Gilad, Shchichi, Rotzchim. There are many Rotzchim in Ever Hayarden. In the north, by Gilad. Gilad, Kiryas, Poyale, Oven, Akuvin, Midam. What is Pshat in Posuk? Omar, Rabbi Elazar, Okvim, Laharog, Nefoshos. They are Orvim, ambush to kill people. So since there are so many Horgim, so many Rotzchim in that neighborhood, they need more protection. The Ramban asks a very, very powerful question. The halacha is that the Ore Miklat is a protection only for a Shoigek, not for a Mezid. So if somebody kills the Mezid, there is no protection Ore Miklat whatsoever. So what is Abaye telling us? That the reason why we need three Ore Miklat by God and Reuven? Because Gilad Shchichi Rotzchim. There are many Rotzchim in Gilad. A Rotzeach is a Mezid. Po'alei Oven. The Mezidim. A Mezid does not go to Ore Miklat. So square one. Why is it that Ever Hayarden has more Ore Miklat in proportion to the rest of Klal Yisrael in Eretz Kanaan? This is the Kasha of the Ramban. And for this Kasha, there are many Terutzim in the Rishonim and in the Achronim. We're going to touch a few of them. Tosfos wants to answer. Al pi agimore makos dav yud omed beis. Anybody who kills be mezid and he doesn't get the deserved punishment, he's going to be killed be shogeg. That says in Shmuel Aleph, Chov Dalet Gimel, Kasher Yomar, Meshal hakad moni, Mireshoim yetze resha. From a sinner comes sins. In Parshas Mishpotim says, Va'asher lo tzido, Vehu Elohim ino leyodo. Two people killed, one Beshogeg, one Bemezit. Both don't get the punishment. There was no Edim. Ze shohorak Bemezit eno neirak. Ze shohorak Beshogeg eno gole. HaKadosh Baruch Hu mazminim lepundek achat. Ze shohorak Bemezit yoshef tachas asulam. Ze shohorak Bemezit yored basulam. Venofel olav vehorgo. This time, the Shogeg killed in front of witnesses. Lepundak. Everybody sees. He goes to Golus. So everybody got the punishment. So Tosfos wants to say, in a place that so many Rotzchim, you need the Meshal HaKadmoni to be Poel, to work. So there are a lot of Shogegim over there. Therefore, they need more Ore Miklat than the rest of Eretz Yisrael. Enochanami, only a Shogeg goes to the Ore Miklat. There are so many Mezidim that they need a lot of Shogegim to be Mekayim the Meshal HaKadmoni. So we need more Ore Miklat for protection. This is Tosfos' answer. But the Maharam is not convinced of Tosfos' answer. Below Mishanemi, the Tosfos did not answer anything. Why? Because in Enochanami there's a lot of Mezidim, but there's not a lot of Shogegim. In Gilad there's not too many Shogegim. The Torah says that in Gilad there are many Mezidim, but not Shogegim. The Ore Miklat is only for Shogegim. So why do you need so many Ore Miklat in Ever Hayarden? Does the Kenim Ba'alei Tosfos give an answer? In Gilad you have Mezidim. In Eretz Yisrael you have Shogegim. This Shogegim will come to Gilad, to the Pundekim of Gilad, to be Mekayim the Meshal HaKadmoni, to kill the Rotzchim that killed without Eidus from Gilad. The Melo, Gilad is the attraction of people that need Ore Miklat more than any place than Eretz Yisrael. So they need extra Ore Miklat in proportion. So this is Tosfos' Teretz. The Chizkuni wants to say a different Teretz. Why do you need so many Ore Miklat in Gilad? The Posik is talking about Gilad is a place of Po'alei Oven Mezidim, and a Mezid does not go to Ore Miklat. The Chizkuni says very simple. So the mentality of a Rotzeach is that he always tries to cover up his killing. Ke'ilo he did it be'eshogeg. even though he had intentions to kill. He makes himself like a shogeg. Memele, he has to run to the Ori Miklat for protection. The Mashal brings a raif in a Mishnah. The Mishnah in the Daftes Omed Beis, according to Rabbi Yosef Rabbi Yehuda, Betechilo, Echot Shogeg, Ve'echot Mezid, Magdimim le'orei Miklat. They go to the Ori Miklat even if they are Mezidim. Nimtza Mezid, Herag. Bezim finds him that he's a Rotzeach, he gets killed. Nimtza Shogeg, Gole. Nimtza Patur, Patruhu. So the Ori Miklat was actually a place for protection against suicide and revenge. The Maharal Miprag wants to say a different teretz. Enoch Hanami, the Posik tells us that in Gilad there's a lot of Rotzchim be-Mezid. But once you have a place full of Mezidim, life becomes cheap. If life becomes cheap, people are not careful how to drive and how to take care of themselves. Memelo, a lot of people will die be-Shogeg because of the lack of purpose in life. The Torah is telling us, since Gilad is a makom from Mezidim, there are a lot of Shogegim. Memelo, you need a lot of Ore Miklat. More than Eretz Yisrael, more than Eretz Canaan. The Ramban says two terutzim. The first teretz says the reason why you need so many Ore Miklat in Ever HaYarden, because the Shetach in Ever HaYarden is equal to the Shetach of Eretz Canaan. And you need to run. So you need more Ore Miklat per square foot. That's a very shvet teretz because people did not spread out. People lived in cities together. Second teretz of the Ramban, that the Cheshbon is very meduyak. There are 48 Ore Miklat in Eretz Yisrael. The Levim get 42 and 6 Ore Miklat. And all of the cities, like the Rambam says, were Ore Miklat. 4 cities per Shevet. So let's make the Cheshbon. In Eretz Yisrael we had 9 Shvotim times 4 is 36 Ore Miklat. In Ever HaYarden you had 2 Shvotim times 4 is 8 Ore Miklat. Now Shevet Menashe had 1 quarter in Ever HaYarden and 3 quarters in Eretz Canaan. So 1 year Miklat in Ever HaYarden, in 3 Ore Miklat, in Eretz Canaan. Comes out that the Cheshbon was very well spread out. 9 Ore Miklat in one side, and 39 Ore Miklat in Eretz Canaan. So it was a very fair ratio. 4 cities per Shevet. That's a very nice Teretz of the Ramban, but the Ponim Yofos has a kashe on this Teretz. According to the Ramban, what's Abaye's kashe? Abaye has a kashe. Why do you have 3 cities in one side and 3 cities on the other side? And Abaye says, because Gilad was a nefishi rotzchim, place full of rotzchim. According to the Ramban's Teretz, it doesn't have to do with rotzchim. It has to do with how many shvotim. So how does the Ramban will learn pshat in the Gemara from Gilad and Abaye? And the Ponim Yofos wants to answer an interesting klal. The Gemara says in Makkos, Rabbi Huda says that in the 6 Ore Miklat there was a special din that was not found in the 42 Ore Miklat. They were separate. The 6 Ore Miklat was special for the Rotzchim, Beshoigig, and they don't have to pay rent. Free in. They don't have to pay for the Levim anything. The 42 cities that belong to the Levim, they have to pay rent for the Levim. So the question is, why is it that the Torah gives it so much, so easy for the Rotzchim in Gilad more than Eretz Canaan? And the answer is, Mishum the Nefishi Rotzchim. There are so many Rotzchim over there that they need more protection. But this is very good according to Rabbi Yehuda, that he makes a difference between the 6 cities and the 42 cities. But Rabbi Meir says that the Rotzchim had to pay rent no matter where, all the 48 cities. There was no Hevdel between the 42 and the 6. So according to Rabbi Meir, how do you learn Pshat in the Gemara? According to the Ramban. So the Ponim Yofes wants to answer with a big Chidush. What do you do if you don't have enough space for the Rotzchim? You have enough houses for or the Levim or the Rotzchim. Who is Doichem ipnei hu? Me nitchem ipnei mi. So Ponim Yofos wants to say that the 6 cities belongs to the Rotzchim. You don't have enough room for the Levim, they have to move out. We need protection for the Rotzchim. So the question is, why is it that we give more protection in Gilad than in Eretz Yisrael, Eretz Canaan? According to the Ponim Yofos, there's a chilik between the 6 cities and the 42 cities when it comes to kedima between the Rotzeach and the Levi. For this, that means chaschino chazakashe. Eini yodeya mokoim ledivroihem. I don't understand what is the mekor from the Ponim Yofos. Where do you find this? But the Netziv says, I found the mekor. It's in Asifrei. Parshe Shoftim. Lonus shomo kol Rotzeach. Shalevim yitno mokom Rotzeach. Dafke in the 6 cities, the Levim have to have Mokom special for the Rotzeach, because they need an extra schus. Why do the Rotzchim in that 6 cities need extra schus? Because in Gilot, Nefishir Rotzchim. So this was the Teretz of the Ramban. There's another Teretz in Sefer, Mishchas Shemen. The Chinuch in Mitzvah Tov Ches Why is it that the Levim make the cities into Orem Miklat? And what happened if the Levim would not be there? So he says, the Levim are Midas HaChesed, and they'll teach the Rotzchim not to do wrong. That's why the cities protect. So the Meshech Chochma says, we have a Gemara in Mesech Tesoite, Dav Memches, that in the second Beis HaMikdash, the Levim did not get the 42 cities. They did not get any cities in Eretz Yisrael. According to the Svara from the Chinuch, these cities will not be Koltois. This is no Shmira from the Levim. But the six cities that Moshe Rabbeinu made, three over here and the Yoshua made on the other side, they don't need Levim. They are Koilet anyways. So in the second Beis HaMikdash, Abai is asking Akasha, why is that we give more protection in this side of the Yarden than the other side of the Yarden? The last Teretz on the Sefer, Yalas Hen, is there a mitzvah for the Goel Adom to kill Erotzer B'Shoigek? Is there a mitzvah for anybody to kill Erotzer B'Shoigek or not? We have a machlokes Rabbi Yosef Aglili and Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Yosef Aglili says a mitzvah for the Goel Adom, and for everybody else is only a reshus to kill. They are permitted to kill. They have license to kill. Every Rotzeach B'Shoigek needs protection from everybody. Rabbi Akiva says no. There's no mitzvah to kill. It's a reshus for the Goel Adom to kill. And for everybody else, it's a isur. Rabbi Kiva's machmir. According to Rabbi Yosef Aglili, we have a lot of roitfim after a rotzeach b'shoigig. Big sakono. Therefore, b'mokom d'shchichi rotzchim. We need more embassies. We need more orim miklat. Atem adeveikim adenoy lechem chaim kulchem hayem.